Hey everyone, thanks for joining Learn to Play Games. My name is Lance, and in today's video I'm going to be playing through the solo mode in Aegis Second Ignition. This is a new game from Zephyr Workshop that is going to Kickstarter. It is a 1-4 player game that takes roughly 30 to 60 minutes to play, and is a competitive game where players are going to be building up a team of robots, moving them around the board, combining them into more powerful robots, all in the hopes of eliminating and annihilating their opponent. Where in my situation, I'm going up against an AI-controlled boss that I'm trying to eliminate before he's able to do too much damage to my valor and eliminate me. So in this video, I'll be playing through and trying to defeat him. We'll see how things go. Now, this is still in prototype form, so all the materials you see here are prototypes and are subject to change, and look a lot better than the final production copy of this. As always, if you find my videos helpful, if you like what I do, please consider hitting that like button and subscribe to my channel. It's one of the easiest ways you can support channels like mine so we can continue to grow, be able to produce this content. If you want to stay up to date on all my videos, also consider ringing that bell so you get notifications whenever I drop new stuff. So let's go ahead and head to the table and we'll see what this one's all about. So the one other thing I want to cover before getting into the video are the Valor skills. So throughout the game, you'll be able to activate some of these skills by spending your Valor points. Now this is obviously going to count against you, so you want to be careful on how often you activate these skills, but they are very powerful skills that can definitely make the difference between winning and losing, and you're going to see me use some of these skills in the video. So there are 5 different skills you can choose from. The first is to change any die to a 6, which can be very, very important, especially as you're going to see. I do use that one to get myself a critical, but you can use this in a number of different ways. Next is to activate another robot. So normally it's going to go from you to your enemy, or from you to the solo boss you're fighting, and you're going to bounce back and forth activating one of your robots, and then you'll activate one of his cards and so on. Now with this, that lets you activate another one of your robots, or if you combine a robot, then you can activate the combined robot on the turn it comes out. So again, very powerful ability. Next is to repair. This one allows you to repair 3 of your hit points, which can be the difference between a bot going down and a bot staying up, which could be very critical. Another one is to change a die value to a 1, and this again can be used even on your opponent. So for example, and you'll see in the video, at certain points when you do damage to the boss, this particular one ports to a different starport, and that could potentially put him out of range completely from some of your bots. So that using that ability would allow you to change that value and move him to the starport 1 if that's beneficial to you. The final one is to add 5 energy to your pool. Again, if you're running low on energy, this could be a critical one, allowing you to make or do a certain attack or do something else that is very important for you at that time. So those are the 5 different abilities. And again, all of these things are prototypes, so some of these might be adjusted or changed for the final version of the game. So just keep that in mind as you watch. But again, these are some really cool abilities you can trigger during your turn to potentially make a difference between winning and losing the game. All right, so before getting into the game, there's a couple of other steps that I have to take care of real quick. So first off, with our boss that I'm going to be going up against, he is going to start the game with 2 minions out on the field, so we have to spawn those first. So let's go ahead and handle that. So we're going to reveal the first one, and it is an AWE-100. So we have to pull his token out and place that out on one of the starting points. So let's see where he comes out at number 3. So he's going to be up here. And then our second minion is an SSM-200. So let me pull him out. And there he is. All right. And then he will come out on, let's see where he comes out at, number 6. So he's way up here. All right, so that actually might work in our favor a little bit. All right, and then from there, then I get to place out my guys. They can start in any of these starting points, and I can divide them up how I want to. So I think I'm going to throw him up there with her, and then I'll put these 3 out here. Let's put him down there, there, and there. Okay. So from there, then we'll move into the round. So the first thing we're going to do is reveal cards from his AI deck to determine what is going to happen this round. So let's go ahead and see. We have, we got one of his big nasty cards out. Oh boy. All right. So we'll have to be dealing with that here. And then from there, we're ready to move into our round, our turn. So first off, I would gather up all of the points that all the energy my bots generate. So right now I generate 20 energy. And then with the solo game, I always start first and it's going to alternate between me and the AI boss. So I'll get to activate one of my characters or one of my bots, and then he's going to get to activate one of his cards and resolve all the effects on it. So definitely has the upper hand on that end of things. And the goal here is either drop him down to zero hit points. That's pretty much the goal, is to eliminate him. And I can do that by hitting him directly or defeating the bots that are out there that he's spawned in. So hopefully with that guy jumping out into number six, he's got only 3 integrity, so I might be able to work on him and get him out of there pretty quick. So that would be fantastic. So we'll see what happens with that. All right, so it's going to move into my turn to start us off, and I might as well take a shot with the armor. And it has a range of 2, so I don't need to necessarily move. And with the, let me make sure he doesn't have anything specific here. Accelerator 5, instead of activating this robot, you may pay 5 energy. Move to 5, okay, so that's not going to have anything to do with us. So I get to hit him, so I'm going to have to spend 2 energy for the attack. This one is going to let me roll 2 dice, and I'm looking for a 2 or better on each die. And for each one that I get a 2 or better on, I'm going to do 1 damage to him. So hopefully this will work out pretty well. And I got a 1 and a 5. So just 1 damage on that one. And so that'll go there. All right. And that is pretty much all I can do at the moment, because I don't really have anything else to handle. So I think that will be it. And then it's going to kick over to the AI. So with him, he is going to first activate his A ability, which is going to have him roll 5 dice. For every 4 that he gets or higher, he's going to deal damage. And he's going to target everybody he has line of sight to. Luckily for me, right now he doesn't have line of sight to anybody, as we're just starting out and these walls pretty much block all of that. So I don't need to roll or resolve that roll because it's not going to matter. From there, then it's going to move on to the minions. So with the minions, all A minions are going to activate, and they're going to start by resolving their attack first if they're able to. So we have the AWE, and it has a range of 4, so it doesn't have enough range for anything, so it's going to simply carry out, if no actions are used, then it's going to move towards the nearest robot. So it is going to move towards one of these guys, and 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right, that is that card activated, so now it is back over to us to go. So at this point, it would be great to take him out. The only other shot I have of it is this one here, because he has a shot at doing a couple of damage. So let's go ahead and try that. So he's going to have to get in close. So 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to have to spend 3 to move, because each energy I spend to move up to a maximum number on his card. So he can move a maximum of 4 spaces. So I chose to move 3. From there, then I do have an attack, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. It's going to cost me 2 energy, and this one is going to have me rolling 2 dice. And for every 3 or better that I roll, I'm going to do a damage. Now, he does have Gambit, which is an ability that lets me pay extra energy to roll extra dice. But if any 2 dice roll below the printed accuracy number, then the entire attack fails. So if I roll a pair of 1s and 2s, I'm out, I'm in trouble. But I would really like this to go off. So I think, do I do 1 more or do I try for 2? I think I'm going to just do 1 and see if I can get lucky with this. So let's see what happens here. And I got 2 4s and a 2. So that worked out really well. And I was able to defeat him. So that will do the boss a number of points of damage based on the level of the bot. So it's only a level 1. So he's going to take 1 damage from that. And then that bot will be removed and added to the discard pile. Okay. So that is the end of my turn there. And so it'll move back over to the boss, who's going to handle his devastation attack. So this one's going to have us rolling 10 dice. For every 3 or better, I'm going to deal 1 damage to your robots. So basically, I'm rolling all of these. And we'll see what happens with this. And there's a couple. Okay, good. So I didn't roll really, really well. Usually I do that very well. So I have 6 hits that I have to distribute among my robots. So I think I'll take 3 on the green guy. I'll take 1 on red. I'll take 2 on red. And then I'll take 1 on purple. All right, so that's a total of 6, so that takes care of that. And then I activate all minions. So right now, he's the only minion that's going to activate. He does have range at this point. So he's going to choose his target. He has range to both of these guys. So Arc is the higher priority based on the different parameters. And it's going to go by alphabetical order first off. So with Arc, he is the higher value. And it does have anti-air. So let's see what that does. Deals 1 additional total damage to enemies with flight. He does not have flight. He has jet, but not flight. So that worked out. And so it's going to have us rolling 2 dice. Both of them have to be 2 or better for this to be successful. And they are a pair of 6s. Wow. All right, so it's going to do 2 damage to red. Oof. All right. That is it for his turn, and he's the only bot out right now, so we lucked out there. And so it's going to kick back over to us for our turn next. And I might just want to retaliate against him, because that would probably be pretty good. Or I could move in and try to hit the boss as well. So let's go ahead and do that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put me there. And then from there, then I can attack because I have a range of 3. Well, I better go here just to make sure that I have line of sight, because I think, yeah, I won't be able to draw a straight line to the center spot there. All right. So that was 5 energy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I'm going to attack with 3. 1, 2, 3. All right. And this one's going to have me rolling 3 dice. And it's only going to do 1 damage unless I get a critical, which is a 6. And then for every 1 that I roll, it recharges the amount on the attack. So let's see what happens here. All right. So I did not get any 6s. But I ain't getting, and I didn't get any 1s either, which is not the best. But I do 1 damage to him. So he's down to 14 damage left. All right, so that's going to take care of him. So I just have those 2 left. All right, moving over to the enemy. Next, he's going to initiate this. So he's going to roll. If he rolls a 1 or a 2, he doesn't spawn. On a 3 or higher, he's going to spawn. And he does. All right, so we have an E coming out. So the Ender 200. All right, so let's see where he comes out at. And he's coming out in spawn point number 2. So he's down here at the bottom. All right, he's coming around the back end there. All right, and then they are going to activate. So just the eyes. So there are no eyes to activate. So when there isn't, then it's going to have us spawn another enemy. So we have an ES. So the ES is actually going to replace the E that is out there. And the S is in the discard pile already, so that works out. So now we have a more powerful enemy out on the field. All right, so we'll see what happens with him. All right. That will finish off that action. So then it's going to move back over to us. Now, at this point, since all of the cards have been resolved, we just finish off the rest of the turn, spending any energy we have left, if we're able to activate our bots if we want to. All right, so I am going to have to spend 1 to move him. And then I get two dice. I'm going to move him 1, 2 into that space, and now I'm adjacent to the other bot. And then I'm going to take a hit and see if I can hit him. All right, so I'm going to get, I need at least, and I rolled another 1. All right, so unfortunately I missed on the attack, but I did roll 1 with the recharge, which gets 2 energy back. So I forgot to spend the 2, but then I get it back. So I'm back to 3. All right, so he is gone, and at this point, and he has the jet, so he can move up to 2 spaces per 1 energy spent. So all that I have left is the IV 400. It has a range of 4, so 1, 2, 3, 4. And there's nobody there, so I might as well just move him. So I'm going to spend the last 3 that I have to move him. 1, 2, 3. All right, that is the end of the round. So at this point, then, we would move into a new round. All of these cards get cleared. We reveal new cards. So we're going to have GE and I. Okay. Then we would regroup and gain our energy back, again, based on what we have. I haven't had any changes or upgrades yet, so that is going to stick there. And we're back into it. So I get to choose who I want to activate. So I'll just move these down again a little bit. And at this point, what to do? I could try to punch that guy again, because he's about to go out. And I do have Parting Shot, which, if destroyed, I deal 1 damage to an adjacent enemy. So I could potentially do 3 damage to him overall, unless I get a critical, which would be fantastic. Which would almost drop him. Or, let me see, where am I at? I'm there, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I could get adjacent to the big guy, too. Let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to spend 3 energy. That's the max I can spend to move. I'm going to move him 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Ooh, before I do that, I almost forgot. There is an end of a round effect. So at the end of the round, I'm going to roll 3 dice. Minions on those star points deal 1 damage to a 3-point radius. So right now, he's the only one on a star point. So if I roll a 2, then my that one's going to take a hit. So let's see what we get here. 1, 1, and 6. So I got lucky there. No effects on that. Okay. So now I can jump into my turn and move him there. And then let's go ahead and take a shot on this guy. So I'm going to have to spend 2 more energy. I'm rolling 2 dice. And I need anything but 1s. And a pair of 3s. All right, so that's 2 more damage to him. So that'll drop 2 more on there. And now another thing he has warp. So anytime he takes 2 or more damage, he is going to warp to another spawn point. Or star point. So let's see where he goes. So he's going to start with point 3. So he's going to pop on up there. Whoop, not me. The boss. All right. So that finishes off his turn, as there's not anything else I can do at this point. So then it bounces over to them. So G is going to activate. There are no Gs, but first off, we have to resolve his effects. So he is going to roll 3 dice. For every 4 or greater he gets, he's going to do 1 damage to every bot that he has line of sight to. So right now, he doesn't have line of sight to her. He does have line of sight to him. And it looks like both of them down there as well, and not that one. All right, so let's see what he gets. And he rolls 3 successful hits. Oh, my goodness. All right, so he's gone, and I'm going to lose a valor for that. And then with this guy, he's gone. We lose 3 points there, so that's a valor for him. And he's gone, as he took 3 as well. So unfortunately, my distribution of damage paid off horribly. All right. Well, I guess it's a good thing I activated him first, because I'm going to be short on activations this turn. Okay, so that takes care of his ability. Now we have to resolve that. We don't have any bots out there, so we're going to spawn a new one, and a G comes out. So the GLA-100, and he's going to come out in spawn point 6. So he's, or the star spawn 6, so he's up there. Okay. That is horrible. All right, so it's over to me. And, oof. So G's done. So E is going to be next. So he's going to activate. So I need to get her out of there. So let's move her. She can fly. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so that is going to be a down to 9. And then I might as well activate her ability. 1, 2, 3. And 3 dice. On a 6, it's a critical. That would be great. And I got a pair of 3s and a 1. So I do 1 more damage. So he's up to 5 damage now. And I do recharge 3 points. 1, 2, 3. All right. This one has a movement of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So I'm good there. And that's everything I can do with her. So then it's going to move over to them. So E again. So he's going to swing again. Same thing. This time it's just going to be her because that's the only one he can see. And he's on fire. 3 more damage. Whew. Then we're going to activate the E's. So just this guy here, he has a range of 4 to 8, but he's behind the wall, so he cannot see anybody at this point. So he's going to go ahead and just move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As she's the closest target to him, and that will finish off his turn. So now it's back over to us. I pretty much just have the one character left. So 1, 2, 3. And then I will go ahead and target him there. It's 2 dice. And if I can... And I rolled a 1. So unfortunately he missed as well. All right. That is the end of his turn, and I moved a couple spaces. It was 2 energy, and then I think 2 spaces. It doesn't matter. I don't have anybody else that can activate at this point. So it's back over to them, and it's going to be I, so he's going to try to spawn another enemy. He rolls a 2, so I got lucky there. No spawn effects. And then the eyes are going to activate. There is no I, so he's going to spawn with this. So the AE is in the discard and A is out. So A will be discarded and the AWE-1000 will come out. So even a little bit better of a robot. Okay, so he's going to be up here. All right, so that will finish off the round. And then there's nothing left for me to do at this point. So that will end the round. And then let's go ahead and handle his ability real quick. So he has that blast again. And there is one down there, but there's nobody even close. So there's no point in handling that. All right. So that's the end of the round. I get my robots to come back out at this point. They're the ones that were destroyed. So I'll get some new robots out there. And 1, 2... So we'll see what we can do here. Hopefully we can keep chewing on him. All right, where do I want to drop these guys off at? I'll go ahead and do that one there. He's got a lot to chew through. I'll put that guy there. And... I Actually, I might just want to go all three up top there to try to continue to work our way over. All right, then I reveal new cards. So we have the S, E, and S. So, oof. So he's going to be activating crazy. All right. That is going to move us into the third round here. I got two rounds left. This round and next round. If I don't get him by then, it's game over. So I got to step this up a little bit. Okay. So, yeah, I guess let's go ahead and try that. So I'm going to go ahead and swing with her. It's going to cost me three energy. One, two, three. It's three dice. And I need a critical here. I got two threes and a one. So I do get three energy back because of the one. One, two, three. And it does one damage, so it's going to keep eating at him. I could spend two valor to change a die result to six, but I don't really see spending two valor for one extra point of damage at this point, and then he's going to move. So I don't think I'm going to do that at the moment. So I think that will be it for her turn. So then it's going to bounce over to the enemy to go. So he's going to activate. He's going to trigger his S result, which is, again, trying to spawn. And he rolls a 3, so he is going to spawn an enemy. And it is an A. So we have that guy coming out. And he is going to bop into location 2. All right. That takes care of his part. Then the S's are going to activate. So just this guy here. And let's see what he's got. He has 4 to 8. So he does have range. And he is going to target. He's going to target this guy here first. Because with alphabetical order, he is going to be top priority. So it's two dice. Both of them need to come up as two or higher. And they didn't. He failed. I got lucky there. Okay, good. All right, and no other effects at the moment. And he's the only S out right now, so that'll take care of that. So it's back over to me to go. Energy spent instead of one. So one, two, three, four, five, six. So he could get there and hit him. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I'm going to spend three for that. So 17. And that'll put me here. And then I'm going to go ahead and attack for two more. And it's two dice. And I need twos or better with a critical coming up. All right. So I think at this point, I am going to spend two. And I'm going to change this one to a six. So that will be in a successful attack, and it's going to be a critical, so it's three damage on him. So that will bump him up to nine damage. So that will help out there, hopefully. And then he is going to, the boss will jump, or warp. He's going to go to spawn point six. So he's all the way over here. That's not good. I could spend two more. No, I can only do it once per thing, so I don't think I can do it there. So he's going to pop up here. All right, so we're going to have to try to work on some minions for now. All right, that will finish off his turn. Then it is going to bounce over to them for ease to activate. So he's going to activate first, and he is going to, he has a range of four, and he's going to target that guy. It's going to be two dice, looking for threes or better. Two hits, one damage apiece. So two damage onto my guy there. All right, and then this guy next. Again, he's going to target the same guy. He rolls a one. I got really lucky there again. All right, so he misses. And then there are no other E's out. So that will take care of that. And he also would have gotten his shot. I forgot to handle that. Does he have line of sight to anybody at this point? I think he does there. I think that'll be it. So let's see if he can. There's a good shot he'll take her down. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right, so she's done. And that's another valor. So we're down to 7. Okay. So that is that. So it's back over to us to go. Let's move him. 1, 2, 3, 4. So he's there. Ah, so close. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to go ahead and attack for 2. Now, he does have Gambit, which means that I can risk spending more energy to roll more dice. And if I get lucky, I can do some extra damage. So I'm going to go ahead and spend 2 extra and try to do 4 dice here. And we'll see what happens. All right, so we've got 3 hits and a 2. Man, that's a tough choice. I could pop it. That does 2 more damage to him, which puts him up there. Otherwise, S, he would activate again. I think I'll just risk it. I'm gonna do the 3 damage to him and let it go for now, because then I'll finish him off, hopefully, with the knight. All right, so then it kicks over to them to go. So the S is going to activate another spawn potential. So let's see if we got another guy coming out. No, we do not. Yes. All right, the S is going to activate, which is him. He's got a range of, he's going to target that guy because he's the closest to him at this point. And that's a range of 4 to 8. So instead, he's going to target him with this. That's a big blast. It's 3 dice, 5s are better, and it's a area effect. And 2 successes. So 2 damage to, so he's down. So I'm going to lose another valor there. And he does 1 damage to him on the way out because of his parting shot. All right, so that one's done. That one takes 2 damage, and that's it. All right. So he's done. All right, and then that's the end of that. So then it kicks back over to us to finish off the round. So I definitely want to get in there with him. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, and then his is going to cost 2. He rolls 2 dice. And a pair of 2s, so that is going to hit for 1 damage. So that will defeat him and add 2 more damage to our boss. That's going to put him up to 11. So he's got 4 hit points left. And this guy's gone. Okay. All right, and then this point, is there anything else I can do? He's got 1 damage on him. He does have flight. So let's see here. I got move 1, 2. Yeah, I might as well just move down a couple because I only have 2 energy left. All right, so that'll finish off my turn. We're into a new round again because, well, no, we have a guy there and a guy there. So, yeah, I guess if it comes up with a 2. All right, so he's going to do his blast. And it's a 2 6s where he's at and a 3, which is here. 1, 2, 3, just short. Okay, so that worked out. These guys are coming back out. I'm going to take my chances and put them, I'll do like this. Yeah, because he's got to get a better chance of getting the 4s. All right. So everybody's back out. We have our final set of cards. So it's a G. There's the big nasty and an A. All right, so it's into my turn to go first. I need to get in there and do some damage, so I'm going to spend 1 energy to move in there. I can move up to 2 spaces, so I'll go there. And then I'm rolling 2 dice. for my attack. I need twos. If I can get a six, that's a critical. Pair of threes. So this is the attack is successful. I'm going to spend two more to bump one of these to a six, and that'll do three damage to him. And then he's going to port or warp away. So that's 9, 14. So he's only got 2 hit points left. So we have a shot at finishing him off here. All right, so we got to see where he's going to jump to. He's going to point 4, so he's over there. All right, and that is it for that. All right. And that's all I can do there. All right, so it's back over to me to go. Back over to him to go. So G's are going to activate. So his ability first. So 3 dice on 4s or better. So 2 misses, 1 hit. And he pretty much is going to hit... I think he's going to hit all 4 of them. All right, so she takes 1, he takes 1. Green takes 1, so that's 3 on green, and red takes 1. Okay. And then G is going to activate, who's over there. Does not have range to anything, so it's simply going to move. And this is our closest bot, so he's going to go there. And from there, let's see what we got here. So green's the only one with any damage on him. So it kicks back over to us to go before the big explosion here. So I think I'm going to have to go all in with her. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 energy there. Brings me down to 11. It'll fly me over here. And then she's going to attack 1, 2, 3. For that, she's rolling 3 dice. Now if I can get a 6 here, that will finish him off. And I did a pair of 6s even. So that is 2 damage onto the boss. He is done. End of story. Right before his big guy was going to go off. So this one destroys all player robots in line of sight, which would have been all 4 of my robots. Whew. And then for the rest of the game, there is no train on the battlefield. So it would have eliminated all of the train. And then on top of that, he activates all of the minions. So that would have been... absolutely devastating. I don't think I would have been able to survive that. Because he's way up there. He would have stayed there. Well, he would have... No, if he would have jumped, I don't think it would have really mattered. He would have gone to 1, which is over here. Yeah, so there's no way that guy was going to get there. And that was it. So it came down to that, and I ended up with 4 Valor points. Well, man, that was a close one. It came right down to the wire, and I didn't have a lot of points left to work with, so things were getting very critical there. The one thing I didn't get a chance to show you is the combination or combining of the robots, which is really interesting and can definitely change the way that the game plays, especially as you take damage, because when you combine robots, everything that they have on them goes away. So any status effects, any wounds that they have on them, all get taken away. And then I did have the Valor skill that lets me activate another robot during my turn. Normally when you can combine robots, they don't activate at that point unless they have abilities, which will activate. And then after that, then they wouldn't be able to activate the rest of the round since they combined. But with that ability, that would let me reactivate them, being able to do more stuff with them as well. So that was one thing I didn't get a chance to show you that's really cool with this. But otherwise, I was really happy with that. It came right down to the wire, one different point, and he would have pretty much wiped out my team, and that would have been it, as I only had 1 card left after that and not much else to handle anything with. So I hope you found the video helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave those in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Or swing by the Kickstarter's main page and drop any questions you have there as well. I'm sure the creator would love to hear from you and is more than happy to answer any questions. Until next time, I'll see you later.